Hello everyone, how are you? Welcome to PHP Advanced Debugging course using Xdebug, which is the best debugger in PHP. In this course, I'm going to talk about Xdebug from A to Z, so that I have divided the course into sections. In the first one, I'm going to explain Xdebug and how it works with PHP and the IDE, whether it's a PHP Storm or Visual Studio Code. In the second section, you will learn how to install, use, and configure Xdebug on any operating system, and we will give Linux as an example. In the third section, you will learn how to use Xdebug with PHP Storm, the best and the most common PHP IDE, and how to step debugging with PHP Storm using Xdebug. And for sure, we will talk about how to use and configure Xdebug in Docker environment. In the fourth section, we will go through the new Xdebug 3 modes. That includes many features, not only step debugging. For example, profile mode, which enables you to make a profile for the whole application or a certain request. Additionally, you can analyze what happened in your code in details to define errors in the code that makes performance or memory issues. After that, we will talk about coverage mode. This mode enables you to make a code coverage detailed report of classes or methods with PHP on it. This will help you define your test quality and where exactly to add more tests. Further, you will know the overall code coverage of your project, and this is a very important factor in quality. The last mode we will talk about is trace mode. It gives you a detailed report about everything happens in your request, from the first moment until the response. For example, how much time did each function take? Which arguments are inputted in this function? What is the return type of function? How many memory did the function use? And how many times did the function be called? This is not only on your code level, but also in the vendor code level. All Xdebug 3 features not only help you to debug and improve your code debugging and gain new experience, it will help you to define and understand the code deeply and define errors in the code that makes time, memory, and tests problems. After that, in the fifth section, we will learn how to use Xdebug with Visual Studio Code, the most popular PHP editor, because it's free and offers many services. We will learn how to configure Xdebug with Visual Studio Code, whether in host or on Docker, how to step debug your code, and how to debug test cases with Visual Studio Code. By the end of this part, you will be highly qualified for solving bugs and understanding a project deeply. The last and the final part will be open and optional, and it will be specified for some topics, such as how to do remote debugging on another server using SSH or remote debugging, and how to debug executed CLI commands like Symfony commands, or how to debug and call APIs using Postman. This is a very brief summary of the course content. I hope it helps people and change the programmer style of debugging in PHP. Thank you for watching, and for any questions, write down in comments or contact me at any social media. Thank you, and see you next time.